Today I'm showing off my recreation of the Red Keep throne room from Game of Thrones, made entirely out of Lego. I designed this completely from scratch over the past year and a half after carefully studying show footage and behind-the-scenes clips. There are around 15,000 Lego parts in this set, and I estimate I've spent over 100 hours designing the room in Lego's digital designer and then putting it together in real life. Throughout this video, I will include Game of Thrones clips and behind-the-scenes footage to show how close my design is to the real set. Here's an example of a similar angle from Season 4. The Iron Throne is made completely out of Lego swords, clips, and spears. It was a huge pain to put together, but it's actually very sturdy. My stained glass windows are made out of transparent parts, which I laminated together for sturdiness. The windows are the only part of this build that use adhesives because the pieces were only held together by gravity and I didn't want to risk bumping them. These are the actual windows from this show that I used for reference. You might be wondering why there are little clips by the windows. During the many seasons of the show, the throne room set has been redesigned, and my throne room can easily be changed to support every version from the show. For example, in the recent Season 7 trailer, the stained glass windows were replaced with large iron Lannister crests. With a couple minutes of work, I can pop out the stained glass windows and use flexible Lego hose pieces to create a similar look. Here's a clip of me changing the windows out to show how it works. The lion is represented by an all-black minifigure with a Lego tail piece. Here is how it looks once all three windows are finished. Here's another shot of the whole throne room with the replaced windows. When I recorded this video, only the first trailer was released, and it wasn't clear that the decorations above the throne had also changed. So now I'm going to need to make a similar lion design for that too. My decorations above the throne are also built to be replaced easily. This allows me to recreate a stained glass window that was there in Season 1. It takes about a minute to take this window decoration out, and about 5 minutes to put it back in due to lots of tricky clip pieces. The stained glass windows are much easier to put in. Once the window is replaced, the throne pedestal can quickly be slid back into place too. Here's the actual window that I used for reference. The original stained glass window depicted a deer by a creek in a forest, and I tried to capture that image in my mosaic too. The final replaceable component of my throne room are the 6 columns in the main hall. In Season 2, Joffrey replaced the original flowery columns with the more menacing columns that have been used ever since.
Turning this room to its proper appearance. Say what you will about the Targaryens, they were conquerors. That is a seat for a conqueror. It needs a room to match it, not vines and flowers.
Let's add the vines back for the Season 1 look. Believe it or not, the vines are actually real Lego pieces too. Here's a shot comparison between a behind-the-scenes clip I used for reference and my Lego recreation. I also wanted to include another full 360 view of the throne room as it looked in Season 1. This was my favorite design for the throne room, so it was really important to me to be able to create this version too. With this set, I can now recreate one of the more exciting scenes from the end of the first season.
All hail his grace, Joffrey of Houses Baratheon and Lannister, the first of his name. King of the Andals and the First Men, Lord of the Seven Kingdoms, and Protector of the Realm.
Here we have Ned Stark entering the throne room with his guards, Littlefinger, Varys, and Janos Slynt. Surrounding them are the gold cloaks. In front of them stand Joffrey and Cersei, protected by the Kingsguard, Lannister soldiers, and the Hound. My hope is that as Season 7 unfolds, I'll be able to recreate even more scenes easily and share them too. There are a lot of interesting building techniques and features which I glossed over in this video, but if you'd like to hear more about how I designed this set and minifigures, I will link some extra behind-the-scenes videos as well. Thanks for watching!